Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 613 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket. The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing burn. Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then yesterday, SpaceX also successfully launched the SDA Tranche 0B mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
1, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff of Space Coast Agency 0B. Go Falcon, go SDA.
Stage 1 propulsion is normal.
The booster which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Stage 1 transonic. Stage 1 landing burn.
And there's that confirmation of landing burn start. This burn should last just around 15 seconds or so.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And there you have confirmation of landing of our Falcon 9 vehicle. This was the 13th launch and landing of this booster and our 222nd overall successful recovery of an orbital class rocket, including both Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy first stage landings.
We can also hopefully expect another Starlink mission to launch very soon. The Starlink 612 mission is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 3rd at 11:25 PM UTC or 7:25 PM EDT. Related to the Starlink launch on Friday, Elon Musk posted saying congrats to the SpaceX team on launch 60 of 2023. Related to the Starlink mission today and the total number of launches this year, Elon Musk posted some more information. He said, "Great work by the SpaceX team successfully launching 61 Falcon rocket missions this year. If tomorrow's mission goes well, we will exceed last year's flight count. SpaceX has delivered approximately 80% of all Earth payload mass to orbit in 2023. China is approximately 10% and rest of world other 10%. He also posted some more launch cadence information. This one says aiming for 10 Falcon flights in a month by end of this year, then 12 per month next year. There is some information related to another launch contract for SpaceX. It says Globalstar has contracted SpaceX to launch Apple-backed satellites in 2025 to replenish its low Earth orbit connectivity constellation. The operator said in an August 30th regulatory filing it will pay a total of $64 million to launch the first set of satellites ordered last year from MDA, which is using Rocket Lab to supply chassis for the spacecraft. There was an article posted on the website of a Japanese telecommunications company called KDDI. It says KDDI and SpaceX today announced an agreement to provide satellite-to-cellular service leveraging SpaceX's Starlink low Earth orbit satellites and KDDI national wireless spectrum nationwide. SpaceX posted information about the Crew 6 mission. They said 1 week after NASA's Crew 7 arrived at the space station, Dragon and the Crew 6 astronauts are set to depart on Sunday, September 3rd. Heading to Boca Chica, testing of orbital launch mount systems has been continuing. SpaceX are doing a bunch of construction work around the launch site. Tent number 1 was seen being demolished in the production yard. As they demolish infrastructure for the new Star Factory expansion, the midbay was amongst those demolished. The Star Factory expansion has also been continuing. Work continues on Mega Bay 2 as stairs were seen being installed. There was information posted related to NASA milestones for Starship. It says, cool fact, the CSCC2 SAAs have listed near-term planned Starship milestones such as first Starship launch with payload Q1 2024, successful Starship recovery Q3 2024, Starship Low Earth Orbit Crewed Space Station PDR Q4 2028. As SpaceX continue to prepare for the next Starship flight test, Ship 25 has received decals like Ship 24 had. I wanted to share a post from What About It related to Starship 25. It says, Ship 25 is undergoing upgrades in preparation for IFT2. It appears that its skirt has been modified to facilitate in-flight engine section purging as evidenced by the cutout holes just above the engine shielding fake floor. The Starship 31 nose cone was seen stacked inside the high bay. Booster 9 was seen performing a spin prime test prior to the static fire. Crews were also seen working around the area where Booster 9's FTS will be installed. It's also believed the flight termination system explosives were delivered. Booster 12 was recently seen fully stacked inside the mega bay. To finish up the video today, there's an updated Starship production diagram to take a look at thanks to the ring watchers. In addition, of course, there's also a booster production diagram to take a look at as well. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.